Hey people, it's Lupita. This is Milan. Welcome to another video. So, or welcome back to another video. What's my intro? I don't know. I think I like two, but I like back. Let me try that again. I think that's good. I don't know. If you could hear that music, I am so sorry. I think my dad's in the garage. And I think he's like cleaning. Actually, I don't know what he's doing, but yeah, so I'm sorry. There's some romantic Hispanic, I'm sorry, not Hispanic, I hate using that. This Latino, Mexican, probably Latino music, Hispanic, I ain't Spaniard, so no. I'm too tan for that. Anyways, I should do an intro. Yes, also. How cute is this? I don't know who did this. I'm so sorry. Maybe I'll have a link of their Instagram. But this, that's my baby. That's Ariana in a drawing. How cute is that? Anyways, let's do this. Hit it. Hey, people, it's Lupita. This is my land. Welcome back to another video. So, hey, hi, hello. As you can tell from the title, we're about to go look into my work pet peeves. Because we all know that our little jobs are kind of annoying. It's just true. It's just how it is, you know? don't be confused. I'm sorry, I'm freaking out. Pause. I need to find a charger because my camera wants to die. Okay. I don't know how long this battery's gonna last because I only let it charge for like 15, 20 minutes, so I better skedaddle. I'm gonna do the intro one more time because I don't trust it. So let's go. Look. I enjoy my job. It's pretty chill, it's pretty easy, and it pays well, and I got awesome friends and people in there. And then I also have my struggles. Annoying customers and difficult bosses, but y'all already know about the manager issues. I don't even have to say it. Anyways, that's not what this video is about, but I do want to preface that, you know, customers are annoying, work can be upsetting, but I know I'm very blessed to have a job, especially in this time. We are essential, so it's like, I don't know, give and take, because I'm blessed to have a job. Also, it's kind of hard to be at risk and being out there working, so it's like, but you know, it's fine, you know, I trust my God, and I will be fine. That's all I wanted to say. Anyways, so before I start, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Become a Lupita Lander. Get your citizenship, get your passport, the whole shebang. Subscribe, and don't forget that bell, because if you don't put on a bell, you won't know when I post. You will never see me again. You can subscribe and still never see me again. You'll be like, who was that? What was the name? Something Land. That's all I remember. You won't remember me. So put on the bell and then you'll see me post a couple times. You'll be like, okay, I think I like her. But yeah, if you don't put on a bell, you'll never see me or this room or my dogs. They aren't here yet, but one day you'll see them. Or look at any one of my past videos. So this is customer pet peeves as a cashier. So this is one thing that really annoys me with customers. They're about to pay and I'm trying to figure out the price because sometimes it doesn't print right on the receipt, which I guess I should explain my job. It's very old fashioned. We don't have scanners. It's not really high tech at all. So, basically it's like a car parts store, so they'll go and order from the counterman, and they know how to do that stuff. They get their little parts and then they have to take the little receipt to me, and they pay me, so I just do the cashiering. And sometimes the price isn't legible, or it's like, I don't know, you just can't see it. And I'm like, oh, how do I figure this out? And like, literally I could take like 2.5 seconds to tell them, and they're like, oh, what, is it free? It's free, right? And I'm like, it's fine, it's a cute joke, I guess, but after you hear it a million times a day, it's just like, it's not free. And you know that we're a small business. Go to, I don't know, AutoZone or whatever other car parts store there is if you want something free. But we can't give it to you free because we'll run out of business in like 2 days. Obviously they don't mean it, but still, it's so annoying. It's like, no, do you want me to pay? Do you want me to get in trouble? I'm confused. Like, no. It's so irritating. Hand in hand with that one, some people will be like, they'll have $300 to pay. And again, I may hesitate for like 2.5 seconds. And then they'll be like, oh, it's a dollar, huh? It's a dollar. Oh yeah, it's a dollar. I'm like, No. It's not a dollar. Like, give me the 300 bucks. Like, you could give me 300 bills, or you could use your credit card, or you could use your debit, but like, cough it up. And then again, I try to put them in order. Y'all already know it's coming. Say it with me. Can I have a discount? What? It's so annoying, because basically the receipt that they give me, that's their receipt. It's printed. I can't do anything after that. Apart from the fact that I don't even have the power to do discounts, like, nope. I'm a cashier. I'm like lower tier. Like, I'm one of the three people that I'll probably get fired first if we have to be laid off, because we're just cashiers. Like, who needs us, you know? I'm basically top tier of the cashiers, but that's practically nothing. Nothing. I'm nobody there, you know? So it's just like, I can give you a discount. I don't have the power. I'm not a manager. Like, I'm a child. Like, I don't know. I can't. Stop asking me. And then a lot of the people that do those jokes as well, they've been there for years, and I'm like, you know, I can't give you a discount, and I wish I could laugh at your joke, but again, I hear it 100 times a day every week, so I can't fake laugh at it anymore. It's not, I can't fake laugh at it. Like, I'll try sometimes, but like, it's just not a part of my soul to be that fake. I can't. Like, I already have anxiety, and it's like hard for me to do like the usual pleasantries that people do in this society, you know, like, hi, how are you? I hate that, by the way. Because it's so ingenuous, like, nobody actually cares, because we're strangers. So people are like, well, you don't have to ask for real, but then what's the point? Just say hi. You don't need to know how I am. I'm gonna lie to you. I'm at work. You think I'm having a blast? Sometimes I am. But you think I'm having a blast? I'm not a morning person. 7 a.m. and you're asking me how am I? 8 a.m. Sorry. I don't start that early. We're closed at 7. No, but you know, 8 a.m. you're asking me how am I? I'm like, I wish I was asleep. I'm not having a good time. Ask me in like 2 hours. Then I'll be okay. And I won't be lying. You know? I don't like it. So anyways, it's just, I can't even fake those pleasantries that well. So imagine having to fake these jokes that I hear a million times a day. I'm like, Next, I'm just kidding. But yeah, I can't. It's a lot. This is another one, again, it really irritates me, because it's just like, I would never say this. Why do people always say this? Like, I go shopping all the time. I make myself broke at Ulta and Sephora all the time, and I've never even said this because I'm not rude. Okay, this one isn't actually that rude, but people always say this, and it's just like, why? I don't understand. So they'll say, you made me broke. What did you say? I made you broke? excuse you. Like, it's so annoying. Some people will have like $200, $100 worth of stuff. And I'm like, are you sure it's not like, I don't know, buying stuff? You're taking stuff home. Like, I don't need to tell you that, you know, you can just leave it. You can keep your money, you don't have to be broke. It's so irritating. Like, obviously they need it because either they're working or they want to fix their car. It's just like supplying the demand. I don't know what the terms are, but like, you needed it, we got it, now give us the money. Like, it's easy peasy. I didn't make you broke, you made yourself broke. Okay, thank you, next. Oh my god. Okay, so there's this customer, little story, what do they call them? I don't know, but yes, little story, mini story time. I'm gonna have a couple in here. There's this customer, and he irritates me because he talks to me in like this little sing-song voice. Every time he comes in, he's like, Lupita, and I'm like, shut up. And like, in my head, like, why does he do that? Why? And literally, it's the same conversation every time he comes in. And he could come in like 2 or 3 times a day sometimes. Like, that doesn't happen every week, but he can do that sometimes, and it's the same conversation. I don't understand, like, why? How do you do that? He doesn't even try. And like, I feel bad because I, you know, it's not an excuse, but I'm gonna remind you again. Depression, anxiety, awkward, anxious. I already said that. I'm already irritable as it is. Also, it's 8 a.m., more irritable, sleepless. That's my own fault, but yes. So, and then this guy just comes in and has the same conversation, which is annoying me. I get a little mean. And I've noticed that he noticed. Like, I used to be sunshine and daisies. Granted, 2 years ago, I felt a lot better at my job. Well, kind of, not really. I don't know. It's a whole thing. But I felt nicer with the customers. The customers didn't bother me back then. But now, now they're kind of rude. Especially in this pandemic. What's wrong with people? Sorry. I'm gonna stop. But yes, so he is one of the people that will be like, you left me broke. I'm like, dude, you got like 5, 6, 7 things. What do you mean? And I'm like, I don't get it. There's this joke that he says, and it only works in Spanish. So he'll say, Lupita, ¿cómo amaneciste? And I'll be like, oh, good. He's like, no, amaneciste de lado. And I'm like, shut up. So basically he'll be like, oh, how'd you sleep, I guess, or how'd you wake up? And I'll be like, oh, I'm good. And he's like, oh no, you slept on your side. And I'm like, are you kidding me? And then he'll say it every single time, I guess, suppose, like, to see if I'll fall for it again. And I'm like, yeah, everybody asks me, how am I? Everybody asks, how are you? So I'm gonna reply because I don't care. So my automatic answer is like, I'm okay and I'm fine and I'm good and that's it. So I'll reply like that and he'll just catch me in his stupid joke every single time. Same joke. It's so annoying. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it! Yeah, so I don't know. When I get really, 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 really bad in my interpersonal, in my, you know, if you have depression, you know, like, you can't deal with people regularly. Like, you don't know how to act around people, which is so rude. So I just stopped answering. I'm like, I'm sorry, I can't answer this again. I know what you're gonna do, and I just don't want to feed into it. If I hear you say it, I'm gonna scream. So I just don't, and it's rude, and I'm sorry, but it's just, I just can't. I can't. Yeah. Okay. Another thing that really annoys me is when I ask, why did I say it like that? I ask for ID because you're using a credit card. They just don't give it to me. There's I think it's one of three things. One, don't you trust me? No, I don't know you. Why would I trust you? This is part of my job. They asked me to ask you for your ID because we're a small business and we can't have you like just keeping money, your money, which is basically our money, and our parts, just not paying us. No, I don't trust you. I don't know you. I'm just doing my job. Leave me alone, you know? Two, they act insulted. Oh my God. They don't ask for my ID at other stores. You're not at other stores. You're at my job. Give me your ID. And three, they ignore me altogether. They just stick the card in the machine. And I'm like, no, I need your ID. I just don't do anything. And I ask for that ID. Or I'll ask for it afterwards. And then I'll be hella rude about it. Sometimes they're so nice. Like, they're like, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to do that. I'm like, yeah, next time you have to give me your ID. I'm sorry. Just give your ID, you know? You have to do it. Why are they so insulted? I don't understand it. Sorry, it just really annoys me. And then there's like a handful, like a little palm full of people. They're like, thank you. I'm like, yes, you're welcome. Nobody's gonna steal your card because I got you. Now, if they go to another store where they don't check, I don't got you. I'm sorry. But you feel me? Like, they should be grateful. Like, I would be grateful. I've lost my wallet a few times. And, like, people have thankfully given it to, like, lost and found and stuff. But imagine if they didn't. Like, they'd be having a heyday just shopping everywhere because these cashiers don't check. So, as my job, I'm a cashier, right? I literally do only two things as a cashier with customers. So if you bring your parts, I could put it on the computer, make a receipt, and then charge you as a customer for it, right? That's one. Or two, I'll charge you as a customer for whatever you've brought. So like you have some oil and you have your little receipt that the counterman gave you. You just come to me and then I charge you, right? Easy, simple, cool. Well, here's the thing. That's annoying. My job doesn't want to have a sign that says cashier only. If you need help with car parts, go that way. If you need help returning, go that way. If you want to pick up some parts that you ordered previously, go that way. They don't want to have that kind of sign. They want me to say it, right? And that's all fun and games. Like, I don't mind. I can say it until tomorrow. I can say it until I fall asleep. I can say it in my sleep. No me importa. But... Si me importa. You wanna know why? You wanna know why? You wanna know why? Because customers will look at me all incredulously and I'm like, dude, believe me, if I could help you, I would. I can't help you. Go that way. They really look at, it's so sad and it really irritates me because when there's a long line, they'll like stare me down and I'm like, I can't help you. I can't help you. And I feel so bad. Like, that's why it's annoying, not because of them. Like, sometimes it is, because sometimes they get pissy at me and I'm like, look, again, I can't help you. That's above my pay grade. Or they didn't even teach me how to do that. What do you want me to do? Like, I'm gonna give you the wrong thing if I even tried, you know? So it's just irritating because some of them will like stare at me and be like, she doesn't want to help, she doesn't want to do her job. Or like some people will like, yeah, just be pissy that way. Or it's sad when they just stand there and stare at me and stare and I'm like, can't help you, please go that way. Or I'll tell them, they'll be like, returns, and I'm like, that way. And they're like, that way? And I'm like, yeah, that way. They're like, okay, you know, like they don't believe me. And I'm like, been here 2 years, I get paid for this, trust me, they'll help you that way. And then they come back and they're like, oh, but now it's your turn. And I'm like, yes it is. It got you now. Now it's my turn. Okay, so it goes without saying. A girl in a car parts store with mostly men, mostly older men, it's gonna be a little problematic. Is my microphone on? Hello? Testing 1, 2, 3. you tend to get some gross comments. I had one customer that was disgusting, and I'm not gonna say anything. I'm sorry, I just don't want to put that on my channel. But yeah, I get like a few disgusting comments. I get a lot of flirting and proposals. Not like that, but like, we should go out. Do you have a boyfriend? Blah, blah, blah. And I'm just like, nope, 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 no. No. It's just like, you could be my father, you're my uncle, and you're my grandpa. What the hell? Okay, I'll say one, only because it's like tame-ish. Literally, my grandfather, that's how old he was, this customer. He was like, I thought he was cool, like, at first, because sometimes they really do seem to look at you like, oh, granddaughter, someone who's just pretty, whatever. I'm like, oh, you're so beautiful, da da da. I'm like, oh, thank you, like, stop it, don't flatter me, you know? But then, like, one day he hits me with, like, oh my god, you're so sexy. And I'm like, my world just... shattered. So I never saw him like that again, and yeah, I was just really dry. So I'm like, I'm sorry, but you can't be that gross. Like, I know I look old, but I'm 25, and in my mind I'm even younger than that. Emotionally I'm a child. It's unfortunate, but it's true. So it's like, let me hide, because it's too much. It's too much. Oh my god. There is nothing that irritates me more than when customers want to rush me. This irritates me. It's like they hand me $100 bill and they want me to give them their change in 2.5 seconds flat. It's like, no, no, no. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, ma'am. Like, you gave me $100 bill. I'm not allowed to use a calculator, by the way. The receipt, it only gives me the total of what they need to pay. It doesn't give me the math or anything like that. Like, I had to learn how to count back and do all that stuff. Like, now I'm so good at quick math, it's weird. Like, I'm an idiot at math and now I'm decent at it. It's freaking me out. It took me 2 years, but I'm decent at it now. But it doesn't matter how fast I try to be, like, they'll still do the finger drumming. Rude. It's so rude. I don't like it. I hate it. It's just like, stop. Also, another part of my job is to check parts, because sometimes, like, countermen will accidentally put stuff in there that they didn't need to, or they'll forget to add something to the receipt that they wanted to buy, like a customer wanted to buy. Or sometimes customers are little shady shades and they'll actually sneak something in there, you know? Or, you know, they'll add it and think you're gonna remember. I don't know what they think. So we started checking parts and I catch a lot of stuff, you know? They either get the parts wrong, sometimes the numbers don't match on the receipt to what they have in person, or sometimes they don't have stuff on the receipt that they have there, or sometimes they have too much stuff and they're being overcharged. So it's like a really good system, but these customers have the audacity to drum their little fingers and try to rush me. And it's like, sir, this is beneficial for both of us, calm down. Like, just because today you didn't seem to need it, like everything was perfect to a T, tomorrow you may be the one who's overcharged $30 because a counterman accidentally added one more thing that you didn't end up wanting. Like, be calm. Like, I don't want to do this. I have to. It's my job. I'm not being a jerk. I would trust you, but also people who steal look like whoever. So it's like, you may seem nice, but I don't know. There was this one customer that I thought was so, like, he was kind of nice. And then, like, yeah, like a year later and a half or something, one of my coworkers was like, oh yeah, he walked out with a receipt. And like, they're customers that are regular, so they know they shouldn't walk out with the receipt because they need to pay it, right? And they have an account at the store, so they're like regulars. So it's just like, wow, he literally walked out with the receipt without paying. Obviously they ended up paying, but now we're watching them like a hog because Why would they do that? It's so gross. It's like not worth it. And I'm pretty sure it wasn't even that much money. Like, I don't know, 40, 50 bucks. It's like, what was the point of that? And that's why you can't trust nobody. And that's why that's a part of my job. So it's just like, calm down. Again, go to O'Reilly or whatever auto parts store. They probably won't care. The thing is though, they don't have countermen like we do at my job because they train and they actually search for stuff. I'm sorry, I'm gonna give them props because they work hard, okay? These countermen, they be doing the most. But yeah, guys, that's it for this video. Those were my pet peeves about my customers at my job and the little annoying things that they do. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know down below if you enjoyed this type of video and if you need or want anything else like this. Like maybe my pet peeves in general, I don't know. But yeah, I have to end this because my battery's about to die again and I just can't take it anymore. But anyways, I love you guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Become a Lupita Lander. Get your passport and your citizenship. The whole shebang. Turn on the bell because otherwise you won't see me ever again. And that's a promise. You want to see me again, so turn on the bell, okay? I love you. I'm Lupita. This is my land. Welcome to Lupita Land. Bye, guys.